So here is a quick update. Last December, end of December, basically I went to Bali, Indonesia for my vacation with my family. And before going to Indonesia, I was contacted by an American startup company to join their team. I discussed with the team and basically I discussed with the co-founders and I liked their idea and I thought to join the team. We need to develop a mobile application and our main target platform is iOS, not Android at the first time or the MVP product. So initially, we thought to use Flutter to develop this application because last few months I was basically working using Flutter and before that I used React Native, and for me Flutter is better than React Native, but later I decided not to move with Flutter, and today I'm going to tell you why. Normally, what happens when you develop an application using the native technology, it is easier to update. For example, I developed some application 2010 using Objective-C. Later, I updated the application with some feature using Swift and later auto layout and many, many things Apple changed over time. But as the use for those applications to use the native platform, still over 8 years, I can easily maintain and update my application. And I have to update this application because those applications generated money for me. So in my new company, our co-founder told me that our main target is iOS platform, not the Android platform initially. So I thought if I use Flutter, there are some risks. Risk number one, Apple may not approve our app. This has happened to me and this has happened for some people. It is not because of Flutter, because of any third-party framework. So for example, what happened to me when I developed a to-do list application and I submitted to Apple, Apple rejected the application by saying that I use any templated framework. So later I reviewed, I appealed and told Apple review team that no, I did not use any templated framework, I use Flutter framework to develop this app. But Apple again rejected my app by saying that this app has minimum functionality. So there is no way that I can approve my application in Apple App Store. And when I searched this kind of thing in Google, I found that some other people also affected using Flutter and submitted their app in App Store and got rejected. So for example, what information I found, some people use some third-party library and those third-party Flutter library use some private API from Apple framework, and using the software, when Apple App Review team review your apps, they detected that you use this kind of private API and that's why they reject the app. So some people basically affected using Flutter or React Native, but not all people. I know many people has approved application in their Apple App Store. So here is my concern. If I invested 2 or 3 months my time to develop an app for iOS platform using whatever framework I choose, but at the end, if Apple rejected my app, then my money, my time, my energy, everything will get wasted, right? So that's the risk and that's the one reason I do not want to happen in this case, and that's the reason I rejected Flutter to use this native application. Another thing is that Apple ecosystem is massive. There are iPhone, there are Apple Watch, there are iPad, there are macOS, there are Apple TV, so many things. And when you use any third-party framework, you should not expect everything or every library is in there. So sometimes it may happen that you have to create your own library to use in that third-party library. So for example, suppose I am doing something that has no plugin for Flutter. In that case, I have to use the Swift programming language to create that plugin for me or for my app. So that's another problem. So if I target one platform like iOS platform, it's better to go to Swift because I can easily update the app. And normally what happens, Swift existed for a very long time and that's why there are many libraries or third-party libraries are in the market, so we can easily utilize those library to create our app. Another thing is important here is that Apple prefers that when you develop iOS app or any app for their platform, you should use the Apple preferred design, that is called flat design, but Google prefer material design. So when if you use Flutter, normally what we do, we use the material widget to create our user interface that looks fantastic for Google platform or Android platform, but Apple do not encourage that you use the material design. Apple encourage that you use the Apple provided flat design. So that's another reason. Though Flutter has Cupertino widget, using that you can create user interface for Apple platform, but I don't think it's a good idea if your target platform is iOS, you use Flutter to develop that app. So recently I got a question from one of my connection that if our target platform is Android, then what we should choose? We should choose Flutter, React Native, or the native Android application development. So if I have to select any technology to develop Android apps, I will definitely choose Flutter, because Android is from Google, Flutter is from Google. So if I develop any application using Flutter, there is no chance that Google will reject my app for their Play Store, right? Because both technology are from them, but Apple is different. So in case I need to develop a new app for Android platform, I definitely choose Flutter, because using Flutter, it is really easy to create user interface. But if I have to choose iOS platform and only iOS platform, then I definitely choose Swift and the latest Swift technology like Swift UI framework. So here is one thing I want to discuss, that recently Apple released, I think 6 months ago, Apple released a Swift UI framework, which is similar to the concept of widget. So if you ever worked with React, JS, web development framework, or React Native, or even Flutter, the concept is basically now in iOS. So previously, when we develop user interface in iOS, we have to use auto layout, drag and drop, and auto layout constant. Sometimes constant become very difficult to handle. Even I found that some people write code the constant using manual code, and that is very difficult to understand. But as Apple introduced Swift UI from iOS 13, and after playing with that Swift UI, I become a fan of this Swift UI, because it is the same concept of React Native, React, or Flutter, basically the declarative UI. In Flutter, everything is widget. In Swift UI, everything is like a view. So there are also local state. If you update the local state, the view will re-render. And there are some other features like how to handle shared state or global state, this kind of thing. So this kind of thing, basically, I like that. And another feature I found that now Apple has a framework, using that you can easily just select a tick in your Xcode, and you can convert your iOS application for Mac application. So that is very good thing from Apple. Currently, I'm mainly focused with Swift UI and latest Swift technology or iOS technology to develop the app for iOS platform. But I will keep my eyes open to Flutter and as well as React.js framework, because I love React.js very much. So sometimes there is no right or wrong answer. So based on situation, you have to decide that what tool or what technology you should use to solve that particular problem. If someone comes to me and told me that I need to develop a cross-platform application using minimum cost, I may go with Flutter or React Native. But if someone came to me and told me that I have to develop an application particularly for iOS with some advanced feature, I definitely will choose Swift and the native technology feature to develop that app. And another thing, I encourage you that if you become a mobile application developer, or if you want to be a mobile application developer, at least try one native technology, either iOS or Android, to become master with that, and then keep your eyes open, play with the cross-platform technology like Flutter or React Native. This basically will help you in your career. Okay, so that's it for today. See you in another video.